Trigger warning. The following video contains very graphic descriptions of acts of violence and self-harm. If you are young or sensitive to content portraying harm or have recently been through any traumatic experiences, it might be best for you to not watch this video.
911 operators, what call scares you till this day? I have one. I worked EMS while my friend was dispatched for this call. I was second, so I never got to interact with the person in question, but I listened to the 911 recording after. Got called to do backup for gunshot wound initially. Farm out about 20 to 30 minutes outside of town. Turned out to be a father who recently lost both his parents within the month, didn't want his family to go through with such loss, either decided to kill his family to spare them that same fate. Father killed mom, two kids. We get a call from the daughter who's about 13. She's been shot in the head but is still alive and conscious. The call was about 30 minutes long, but the father was in the same room as her and the rest of the recently murdered family members. She was sitting on her bed with a bullet in her head, just saying in the most monotone voice, "I've been shot, my family is dead, my dad has a gun." Just in so much shock that she couldn't express an emotion. You could hear long pauses of silence as the dispatcher tried to get an idea of the situation, and the daughter and dad were just staring each other down for 5 minutes at a time with nothing but breathing to be heard, and the daughter answering the dispatcher's questions. About 30 minutes go by of dispatcher going, "Are you alright? He's still there? He still have the gun? Etc.?" And just monotone responses. You can hear the sound of sirens in the background, and the father leaves the room followed by a gunshot. The dad shot himself and died right as we were pulling up. She ended up living, but had lost every single member of her family that week. I don't know what happened after all that. That call is the reason I never wanted to pursue dispatch ever again. My friend was an absolute champion for how he handled it, but he never wanted to listen to it again. I have two. It was my second week, and I was plugged in with another dispatcher who was handling calls, and I was working the computer and stuff as part of my training. We got a call from a guy in a car, who said that he was in a near accident with another driver, and the other driver was following him and being aggressive. The dispatcher told him to turn around, and look for a well-lit, busy place, like a gas station to stop, and we would have someone on the way to meet him there. He was shot 5 times while on the phone with us, waiting for the officer to arrive. I found out the next day on the news that the guy flew in from out of town to walk his daughter down the aisle. 2, a month or so later, at the beginning of my shift, I received a call from a very distraught man whose dad had gone missing from his care facility. He had dementia and his dad thought he might be looking for a bar to get a drink. I took his information and got a description, and put out a bolo for him. For these calls, we normally don't find out the outcome. In this case, one of my last calls that same night, was a person calling who found a body on some train tracks, and it turned out to be the same guy I had put out the bolo for. I had to call the deputy who went and took the guy's statement and tell him the news, and he then had to go tell the guy's son. That was a shitty end to the night. I shattered a 911 operator. We got a call from an 8-year-old who said his big brother was in the bathroom and hasn't been out for an hour and there was no sound. He broke the door open somehow while he was on the phone with us, and his brother was dead from suicide, hanging. This was small town, and a year prior that same older brother had called in when the mom had committed suicide herself on pills. Hearing that kid cry will always haunt me. I decided not to become a 911 operator. Not one specific call, but suicide calls where the caller has no interest in seeking help but just wanting the police to find them before their family does. Knowing you're likely the last person to speak to someone and there's nothing you can do to help is pretty rough. A guy in my neighborhood killed his whole family, then called 911 and told them what he had done before killing himself. I always wondered what it was like for the person who took that call and the cops who showed up to find the scene. I knew the son pretty well. I was on my way to school that morning when the cops were rolling in and blocking off the street. Former 911 operator here. Sometimes the calls that stick with you aren't the most physically traumatic. I once had a call from a 17-year-old kid who came home from a sleepover to find that his mother had moved. Just packed up his sister and everything in the house and left while he was gone with no forwarding address or information. She also turned off his cell phone that morning, so literally the only number he could call was 911. He was trying so hard not to cry and his voice was shaking as he kept apologizing to me for calling 911. He just didn't know what else to do and had no other family. She also took everything, so all he had was a couple of things that he had taken to the friend's house. He told me his 18th birthday was in a couple of weeks and he literally had nothing. The officers that responded took him to a shelter. I think about him often and I hope he's okay. Even if he was a kid who got in trouble or had behavioral issues, I can't imagine coming home to find your mother has abandoned you. Family member worked as police dispatcher. Received a call from an elderly woman. Her husband had just been killed in their garage by an intruder. She heard it happening, she's wheelchair bound but phone was next to her. She frantically begged my family member to help her. While he was on the phone with her, the criminal cut her throat. My family member stayed on the line 3 more minutes until cops got there. He could hear the sounds of the attack, her gasping and gurgling noises. He kept telling her help was coming and to hold on. Amazingly, she survived. Criminal was later caught. A 17-year-old who just wanted the thrill of killing someone and picked them at random. He's on death row now. Didn't really scare me, but touched me deeply. Lady calls in, she stopped to visit elderly couple she knew because she had not heard from them. The elderly man had dementia. Apparently his wife died in her sleep days before and he didn't realize and had been getting in bed with her nightly. Every call where someone is reporting an unresponsive relative. Some will let you walk them through the CPR process if they don't know it, some won't. Every one of them you hear the caller at some point pleading with the patient to not leave them. Most times they do though. Parents, spouses, children, I've had them all call. Never gets easier. My husband died of a sudden heart attack. I feel terrible for the 911 operator who took my call. He had passed by the time paramedics got there, so the guy on the phone with me had to listen to me scream and cry and beg. I cannot imagine having to hear that at my job. I was a 911 operator. When I asked for the address, I got an angry man yelling, "Just get the fucking ambulance here." When I asked what happened, the caller said, "You don't need to fucking know that. I just need to know what happened so I know who to send and what equipment to bring, sir. Just send a goddamn ambulance, my kid's having a seizure. Don't send any fucking police." Don't send police coming from a caller is basically them telling on themselves. Please send police, because the patient or the EMS crew or both could be in danger. So I passed a note to my partner, who was dispatching, "Send PD." Extremely uncooperative caller. I tried my best to get through the rest of the questions, how old is the kid, are they conscious, are they breathing, has the seizing stopped, etc. I got nothing but verbal abuse. All I knew is that a pediatric patient had a seizure when the call started, there was yelling in the background, and there was some terrible yelling in the foreground. "Put your hands up. Hey, what the fuck, bitch." And that was it. Police had the caller. The patient ended up being a toddler, who had been beaten to within an inch of their life by that asshole. That was terrifying and sad, and I hugged my own kid a little tighter that night. Got a 911 call with just screaming. Nothing intelligible, just the loudest screaming you've ever heard. I started officers to the house. Then a kid started yelling that her uncle was trying to kill her, her sister, and her grandmother. She started screaming again, there was a thud, and then no more sound. Officers got there and a man walked out into the driveway and said, "I did it. I killed them." He was mentally ill and lived with his mother. She had been trying to get him committed, with doctors saying he wasn't a danger to himself or others. His 9-year-old twin nieces were visiting from out of state. He snapped that morning. Bludgeoned them all with blunt objects, including a large vase. His mom and one niece died. One twin survived with extensive injuries. It was a horrifying call. I have two. A call from a male who stated he'd found his girlfriend's son unresponsive. Very frantic caller. He and the mother passed the phone back and forth multiple times while I tried to give various rescue instructions. That part wasn't all that abnormal, but they later took the male into custody and I found out the initial caller had strangled the kid and then freaked out and called. Still makes me mad, and it's been years. Not mine, but a call they played for us in state training. An elderly man had a complete psychotic break and killed his wife with a hammer. Afterward, he calmly called 911 and confessed. The dispatcher attempted to give rescue instructions, up until he realized the damage was extensive enough that her head was mostly gone. Several of the first officers on scene were violently ill because of how bloody the house was. Nearly 30 years ago, my grandma was a widow living in a Florida retirement community. The landlords allowed a man in his early 40s live in the community despite strict rules regarding age minimums. He ended up going on a drug-induced rampage, stabbing his son and girlfriend. My grandma was getting her mail and he chased her all the way back to her doorstep and stabbed her over and over. She managed to crawl back into the house and call 911. We listened to the call during the trial, and it was absolutely one of the hardest things I've ever had to sit through. You could hear the man screaming outside the house. The 911 operator was very calm and trying to keep my grandma alive till help arrived. The guy took off in a stolen car and headed towards Georgia, going the wrong way on the highway. My grandma was airlifted to the nearest hospital and barely survived the attack. 370 stitches, including on both sides of her throat and all over her head. I firmly believe the calming, caring urgency from the dispatcher helped keep her going. Former Leo. Had a dispatcher that needed some therapy after this one. Rural County Sheriff's Office is where we worked. Dead of winter. Roads were slick with a glaze of ice on top of the driven-on/hard-packed snow. A rural mail carrier had lost control of her vehicle and rolled her Jeep Grand Cherokee on its top. Due to her delivering mail, her window was open and during the crash the vehicle had rolled on top of her arm. She was pinned but managed to call 911. While en route, we could hear the panic in our dispatcher voice when she said the vehicle had caught fire. On a summer day it would have taken us about 15 minutes running lights and sirens. Due to road conditions it took about 30. Every time my dispatcher keyed up on the mic to give us further information, I could hear the screams from the caller. By the time we got there she had expired. Our dispatcher listened and tried to talk to this woman while she was burning alive. She was absent for like a month while she got everything sorted out. I think of both of them often. I'm going to do another one because this thread is a bummer and we all need a laugh. I am, I assure you, not making any of this up. There was a ranch on the edge of the city limits in my area, right by a large park and swimming hole. That ranch had a variety of livestock, but they had an issue with their pygmy goats. Every few weeks we'd get a call because 100 little goats were roving through the park or down the street. One day, I took that call, from a man in the park who had been chased by the goats into a porta potty. He was frantic. Like, screaming. You need to send animal control out here right now. And all the while, I could hear two other prominent, repeated sounds, the whack of little goat noggins rattling against the plastic porta potty, and bleeding. Malevolent, incessant bleeding. What did those goats want? What would they have done, had he not found refuge? We'll never know. Peace was never an option.